What's happening, folks? It's your guy Rashad out here at Action Sports Bar and Grill in Kent, Washington with another Follow Me to Work, day in the life of a food truck owner. This is a snow day edition of Follow Me to Work. If y'all don't know, Seattle is not set up for snow. I know, it's weird. You would think every city is set up for snow, but there's hills everywhere. Pretty much the whole greater Puget Sound area in Washington here, there's hills everywhere, and like an inch or 2 inches of snow shuts it down. I know that's weird for people who are like in California, or not California, Colorado or Buffalo, New York, or you places where it's really heavy snow, hell, even Eastern Washington. But in Seattle, 2 inches of snow is like cancel school on the wrong day. Let there be some ice. They shut it down. So I know y'all are going to be looking at this amount of snow that they canceled school for and think to yourselves, what the hell? Especially if you're from some place where it snows a lot. But I'm just telling you, in Seattle, a little snow is a lot of havoc. We were supposed to do a service for lunch at one of the local college here in our city. We love going up there and hooking up the kids. It's a good place. Our food does great there. So we were excited to go. 11 o'clock service, 11 to 1 that service usually runs. So 11 o'clock service means our load-in time starts about 8:30. So for me, that means, an earlier day to get the truck gassed up and fueled up and everything up there. So, we spent all morning getting ready for it, the night before prepping for it, and then to have it canceled, a lot of people would be kind of demoralized about it, kind of pissed off about it. But for us, this whole thing was kind of just another example for us. If we just stay ready, and we're putting our best foot forward, good things wind up happening. So, wasn't the service we planned on having, but the thing I talk to my team about a lot, and people will hear me say a lot, is this industry is about being able to adjust, and the people who are better at adjusting and adapting, they just do better. If you're real rigid in your plans and you need to try to control everything and everything has to go a certain way, I probably wouldn't do it, hospitality or restaurant or bars or food trucks, because it doesn't really work like that for us. Shit is always changing and you need to be able to adapt and pivot on the fly. So this was just another good example of us being able to do that. It turned out to be a profitable day for us. It wasn't the service that I expected. But again, if you're ready, you can always pivot and try to turn it into something else. For me, it's a little easier because I have a brick and mortar restaurant and bar already that I can, for us, we just opened up the doors and sold right in front of it. But we've had those opportunities and days like that turn up where we weren't close to the brick and mortar. And so we just had to think on the fly and try to come up with something else. Cutting your labor is a quick way to do it. I'm free labor. I don't cost anything to the business to be there doing the thing. So on a day like this, I cut the truck manager at the time to save myself some cash, and then was able to turn it into at least a break-even service, because even though I didn't do the sales that I would have, if we were at the college, we were able to do some sales out in front of the bar, capture some of that, take care of some of my regular guests that way, and it didn't really cost as much because it was really just me working the majority of the day. As always, if you like the video, please let us know. Share, subscribe, sign up for the notifications. We're going to be doing more of this stuff, some behind the scenes, all the stuff that you guys want to see having to do with bars and food truck. Let me know in the comments, because we're trying to give you the content that you want too. So day in the life, food truck owner, Action Food Truck, playing in the snow. Morning, folks. Another beautiful day here in the Pacific Northwest. Decided to snow in November. Stupid. Got stuff to do today. Food truck event going on. Supposed to, at least. So, got to run up to the bar and get some stuff set up before I go back down, get myself cleaned up, get the truck and get presentable. So yeah, thought I'd bring the puppy dog with me since, you know, making a trip up to the bar. And if I take her, it will make me be fast because she can't sit forever. It'll force me to only stay up at the bar for the 30 minutes I need instead of spending too much time up there. So when I have stuff to get done and I need to stay on schedule, I bring my co-pilot with me, and then that way I'm flying super quick. Huh, puppy dog? Huh, baby? What you see out there? She's the best. Went down to Top Down Brewery in Sumner, and they had their little mascot, Frenchie, French Bulldog, had one of these bandanas on for Hoppy Dog. So, you know, we had to pick one up for the puppy, you know, because she got to stay geared up. Puppy dog needs swag, too. All right, y'all. Anyways, as you can see, the stupid snow back there. I'm going to drive safely, turn this damn thing off, hit the four-wheel drive in the RAV, baby. The RAV, baby. He said, what the fuck I rap for? To push a fucking RAV 4? Yes, Kanye. That's exactly why. It's to push a RAV 4. I'm not even going to get started on him. But anyways, y'all be good. Be good at it. We'll see you later on. What else we got to do, Roxy? Anything else? You got anything for the people? Anything you want to say, Roxy girl? Here's your cameo. Anything you want to say? No? Nothing? My puppy? What you doing? You don't want to be a, you don't want to be a star? No? Okay, pretty girl. You're the best. Test that out today. Your early prepping for lunch service at the college. Let's get it. Service anyways. As long as the college is open, we're probably going to go up there and feed them. Roads don't look too bad. If not, that's the beauty of having a brick and mortar. We got all this food, we just pull up right out in front. And we already here. Just pop open the doors, let's go. Service for lunch, but as you can see, the weather is doing it today, so we shall see. Big girl, see how she handles in the snow, I guess, huh?
You feel like, how we know that God is still in control. Hey. Yeah, we all season truck. We're ready for everything. Except for when the place we're going to serve for lunch cancels school. That's all right. We're all loaded up. Got a ton of smoked meats. We're going to stay right here in front of the best bar in Kent. Slang some of that smoke-enhanced bar food. Come through, y'all.
The other positive and kind of cool thing that came out of that being ready to rock and roll one way or the other was that because so many places had closed for that day, not just restaurants, or not just the school, but also restaurants and other businesses were closing all over town, it then became a local news story about what's going on out in the snow. And because we were open, because we were on our socials early, because we let everybody know that no matter what happened, we'd be ready to rock and roll with some good food and have the bar restaurant open. One of the local news channels caught wind of that, came down, did a little, you know, 30-second, 60-second interview, took some photos and video of the truck, and what turned it into, you know, what was going to be a bust of a service turned into kind of a little PR for us. If you're a new truck, any positive exposure you can get like that is great. And like I always say, when it comes to my competition in this bar game, in this food truck game around here, my competition is all local. It's everybody who's within, you know, 45 minutes, an hour to me. So to be able to get picked up on a one little, you know, 1 minute segment on our local news is positive for us. It wound up on the news throughout the day. So three different times throughout the day, we got this little segment, and, you know, people were reaching out saying, oh my gosh, you're open, and we're going to come by and grab some stuff. So all of that comes out of being ready to rock and roll from the beginning. If we didn't prep, if we weren't ready to do it, if we were just hoping that school canceled and half-assing it, then the opportunity wouldn't have presented itself. So that's why I say always stay ready. You don't even have to trip about the shit. But all in all, it was a pretty cool day. Sales were low, but they were definitely better than what I would have had if we, you know, weren't ready.